And what does all this come down to? It comes down to core ideological perspective, either the self or the collective. And if you're out there not wearing a mask, it's about the self. It's certainly not about the collective.
And now for something completely different.
Welcome to
Surrounded by Idiots
Radio Podcast.
From the Java Bud Studios in beautiful Scottsdale, Arizona, United States of America, this is the Surrounded by Idiots Radio Podcast. Hey, how is everybody doing with everything going on? Hopefully things are better. Well, you're hanging in there. You've got some support. Things are okay at this point, and I really hope so. A couple things I want to do at the beginning of the show here. The first thing is I want to rep this guy, Dave Pell. I'm wearing the shirt today. I went and I actually purchased the cotton. The app is called Next Draft. It's free. And basically, it's a rundown of the 10 stories, 10 news items that Dave has found during the day that he surmises and he puts them together and he has a little pithy comment at the end. And I find it a really good read. It's real quick to get through. The second thing I want to mention is something that is a little embarrassing. And it's the fact that my birthday is coming up. It's on the 19th of June. It just so happens to be Juneteenth as well. And up until this year, which will be my 55th birthday, I really didn't get it. I mean, I kind of knew what it was because I heard about it, and I'm kind of a history nut anyway. And so I knew that it was a celebration of the end of slavery, but I really didn't know a whole lot about it, nor did I really give it any attention at all. But given the current circumstances and the current higher level of clarity that I have, I'm a little embarrassed that I didn't give it more consideration. And I think that that goes back to what I was talking about last week in regards to just not being aware. Now that I'm aware of that, it's kind of cool that my birthday lands on a very significant day like that. So if for everybody out there who is looking to make it a holiday, I hope that that happens to be the case. And happy Juneteenth to everybody on the 19th. So last week and the week before, there was a lot of discussion on this show, mostly about politics and the protests and Black Lives Matter and awareness and clarity and expansive thinking. And it seems like things are going the right direction. Although remember, like I said last week, it's going to be one of those things where it's going to be 5 steps forward and 4.5 steps back. And the 4.5 steps back is going to be painful. Because once things are exposed, it's a situation like I talked about last week where you can't unsee them. But we're going to have to live with them for a little while until we find a way to move the needle collectively. And the good news is I think we have the tipping point in regards to the number of people and the way things are going. And hopefully, fingers crossed about the election happening in November. And that momentum going forward, I think we're on the right track. So please just be patient and please continue to put the foot down on the pedal in regards to keeping the pressure on with politicians, keeping the pressure on with doing the things that we need to do to collectively expand the awareness of society in terms of looking at things consciously from a more equal standpoint. So this week, I'm going to pivot back to the virus, and more specifically, I'm going to talk about wearing masks. There's no surprise that cases are going up. States opened up too early and people are getting together. Makeout sessions are happening back in the bathroom hall. Cats and dogs are living together. Everything's going back to what it was before and cases are going up. And now it just so happens that being in Arizona, I'm at one of the hot spots. The hospitals at this point are at almost maximum capacity in terms of the ICU for COVID-19 patients. And yet, Governor Doug Ducey of Arizona has still not mandated or required people to wear masks. And I quote, gives local governments authority to require masks in public. So basically what Ducey did, Republican governor, he did the same thing that Trump did. He passed the buck and didn't want to take responsibility for creating some sort of mandate or some sort of requirement that would help everybody out in the long run to stop the spread or at least to slow it down to where we could get a handle on it like we almost did before people started going out again and doing the same stuff because they got impatient and they got tired. If you don't know or if you don't remember, my daughter had leukemia last year, just last year, and fought it and is cancer-free, but she's still in recovery. She is still on medication that suppresses her immune system. Her system to fight off things like COVID-19 is being artificially suppressed, artificially held back by medication, which means we all have to be really, really careful because she is in the high-risk category for getting COVID-19. And she's not a political person at all. She finally said, I have to do something about this, and she wrote a letter to Governor Ducey. And the letter basically stated who she was, the battle that she's going through, the scientific-based information that is out there that shows that it has some level of effectiveness, and asked him why he didn't mandate the wearing of masks. So after reading the letter, I encouraged her to post it on Facebook because I thought it was very powerful, and it gives everybody around us, at least in her Facebook circle, which is huge, an idea from the perspective of somebody that could be severely impacted. So the arguments against the mask out there, the ones that you hear a lot about, include this old research based on different contexts of mask wearing and saying, oh, see, well, they say that it doesn't do anything, or it's not effective, or it's more harm than good, and so it shouldn't be the case, which has nothing to do with the current situation. And it shows an ignorance in the scientific method. They also argue that it doesn't prevent COVID-19, so why should they wear it? They also say that it infringes on personal freedoms. You're making me do something. It's like a petulant child. If you tell them something to do, then they're not going to do it. And why? Because you told them to do it. And now masks, of all things, are political. So they're thinking that I can't wear a mask because it shows maybe, or the impression might be, that I am politically leaning towards this side versus what my real thoughts and feelings are about things. Then we can get into the basics of just being uncomfortable. Then I've heard some people say, well, I'm not going to wear it because I can stay 6 feet away from everybody, and so that's not a problem. Another thing I've heard recently is that people are having a hard time believing in the science because they believe that epidemiologists and scientists have contradicted themselves recently when they talk about the protests and COVID-19 and social distancing. The last thing I heard was specifically towards the president and the vice president, and it has to do with the fact that they don't wear masks because they have access to constant testing. In looking at the psychology and the philosophical basis or background of the reasons why people don't want to do that, there's a little more to it. For some, wearing the masks are emasculating. They represent submission and weak. For others, it can validate a loss of identity and power and individuality, making you look like everybody else, making you act like everybody else. And most of that's just an ego pattern, and it comes from binary thinking. And it's from believing that the identity is based on physical existence and the ability to be seen and heard. It's not based upon an intrinsic belief that you have an identity. I can feel and touch myself, I can see myself in the mirror, therefore I am. When you tell somebody that they have to wear a mask, and then they cover their identity, and they can't see that in the mirror, there's the problem. There's also a thing called vice signaling, if you haven't heard about that. It's an acting out of malice and cruelty towards the weak. It's saying, we're in a position where we can be tested. We're in a position where we are healthier. We're in a position where we have levels of authority and money enough to take care of it if we get it, and we don't have to worry about it as much, but you do. And so what we're going to do is not wear the masks to continue to reinforce to you externally or physically the fact that we don't have to. Now, that's deep psychology stuff, but I really think that that is a vein that's running through this whole thing, along with the concept of not wanting to create a common bond because you don't want to agree on anything. And what does all this come down to? It comes down to core ideological perspective. Either the self or the collective. And if you're out there not wearing a mask, it's about the self. It's certainly not about the collective. Because if it was about the collective, and you understood that being around me without a mask, even if you're 6 feet away, you still don't have a mask on, and I have a mask on, but that won't prevent 100%. And the reason I do is because of people like my daughter that are counting on us to make the right decisions. They're counting on us to be the leaders and for us to be the change and for us to model good behavior in this situation. It has zero to do with politics. It has everything to do with health and safety and life. I'm not out there wearing a mask only around Democrats or only around people that believe politically what I believe in. I'm wearing a mask around everybody just in case. Because I'm doing it for you, because I want other people to do it for me and for my family. But the good news is I think the pushback is happening more and more. And this is just another fight in this whole situation. I see social media posts all over the place trying to provide a level of perspective on just wearing a mask. And they're talking about, listen, my grandmother survived the Holocaust and you have a problem with wearing a mask? So I always end the show on a call to action. So please wear your mask and gently advocate to get others to do the same. Hope things are good with you. Remember, you can go to javabud.com for everything. Alexa Flash Briefings, YouTube for the videos. If you have any questions or comments at all, if you want to talk to me at all, if you're having a hard time about this at all, please get a hold of me. It's tony@javabud.com. T-O-N-Y @JAVABUD.com. Stay safe, stay well, be good to each other, wear a mask, and I'll talk to you next week.
I'm too tired to pretend. I don't want to be alone. I'm calling all friends.